Hi, it's Marco Van Basten. Welcome to another edition of Van Basten's UK Tube. Today what we're going to do is build one of these. And this is a black 3.7 volt DIY box mod kit which I received from Rob at www.stealthvape.co.uk. I'm going to take you in a close-up. We're going to build this from the beginning and then we're going to come back and see how it vapes. See you in a few minutes. Right, well, here I have the kit that gets sent out from Stealth Vape. We've got the battery holder box mod here. I've got a horn button and I've got a tricolour LED with the resistor that comes with it. And if you open up the battery box, what you will see is obviously the battery connections, and this one here is the negative, obviously positive here, and then a pre-wired 510 connection. And what we do need to do is we need to take away some of this in order to get the button in properly. So we're going to use that using my Dremel type tool, which actually isn't a Dremel, but it's similar, and it comes from Maplin's. I've got two different versions of this tool. I have a powered version, which is plugged in to an adapter. I've also got a battery version, and that's what I'm going to use right now. I'm just changing the tip on it to a little cutting disc. So that's what we're going to use. It's quite handy. It's variable speed with a 8mm shank, I think, on there. And I'm using a set of tools that I got from an auction site. They are diamond tipped and they're quite good for plastic and metal. And I've been using it on another box mod that I've been working on, using a tin. So what I'm going to do is just take out a little section here in order to get the button in properly. Although this has been drilled, I think it'd be a little bit better to make that area a bit more tidy. So forgive the noise. And there we go. Now, if you don't wear glasses, I do advise you to put some sort of eye protection on, because the plastic can jump out quite a lot. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take a little bit more off this side, so there's a complete area around where the switch is going to go. So as you can see now, I've cleaned that area out, so where the button goes in, I'll just show you that now, just taking off the background, the back of the button. And now you can get very easily the button and the nut attached quite nicely. So I'm just going to get rid of these bits of plastic. So let's fit this properly. Button's going on. I'll put the spring washer and then the nut. And at this stage, I'm not gluing anything. I'm just going to do everything finger tight. There we go. And that's the button in. What I do want to try and do is keep these contacts pointing in this direction. And believe it or not, this is the first time I've made this kit, so you are seeing it as I'm doing it. Right, there we go. That is now on. So, the next thing I need to do is think about where my LED is going to go. And in the clear box, it suggested that you just have the LED somewhere around here so you can see it. There is, at the bottom here, a little hole. And the LED will fit in that hole, but not without a little bit of work to make that big enough. So one thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get rid of this little section here, and this is where the negative would have been. So I'm just going to get rid of that bit. And that is a little bit better now. And then it's a case of making the hole in the bottom there a tad bigger so that the head of this will fit in. And for that, I think I'm just going to use this little tool. So I'm just going to change over. Got a different shape on. And I'm just going to enlarge this hole. Aha, there we go. Right, now that is the perfect size for this LED to fit into. This will all be secured with some glue when everything is tested and I know it works. So there we have our LED just in the hole. And what's going to happen is one of these poles is going to one side of the switch and the other one is going to the other side of the switch, and then the middle one, this middle prong, is going to go with a resistor to the negative on the battery connection. We also need to wire this length to one side. So what I'll probably do is cut this to length, solder here, cut the other positive to length and solder there. And then we're going to cut this, solder to the negative, and then we'll use the excess to connect up our LED. So I'm going to cut all these to length, and then we'll get the soldering iron out and get it soldered up. See you in a minute. Right then, I'm back again. We need to do a little bit of soldering. And what I've done is I've just tidied up all the wires and I've made them all the right length to what we need. And we just need to get some solder onto these wires so then we can start putting things together. So I'm just going to put some solder on my soldering iron and put some solder on these wires. I'm using 0.2 wire. It's the wire that came in the kit basically. I just need to get some on the ends of these wires. I also need to get some on the end of the resistor, which I've cut to size as well. Don't need a huge amount, just enough so when we touch them with the other one it will make a nice connection. And I'm using my little helping hands here just to hold the solder so I can hold one thing at a time. And we're going to do the same with the battery connections. I'm using multi-core lead-free solder. And this is a solder station that I got from Maplin's. Okay, so now what I need to do, I'm just zooming slightly for you so you can see this. I'm going to get rid of my helping hands just for the second, get them out of the way. I'll zoom in for you. So what we need to do now is just solder on. You can see the two connections here. Turn it around that way. Move those out of the way. You can see the two connections here for the LED. So I'm just going to solder those on to the switch. Get plenty on there. And then the same here on the other side. Need to be careful not to heat it up too much because it won't do the LED any good. I'm just going to also put a little blob on the end of this one because we're going to connect that up shortly. And also I just need to put some solder onto this negative connection because we're going to be attaching the wire, or the negative wire, from the battery connection onto this. So we're about ready. I'm just going to bring the hands back in again and going to connect up my resistor. Solder on our wire. Very fiddly. There we go. So that's one side of our wire. The other side of the resistor is going to go onto the battery connector. So we just now need to put a little blob of solder on the battery connector. Be careful not to get that too hot either, because the heat will transfer up to the plastic case. But we really want to melt the plastic case. So now we need to start soldering up our connections. So we're going to do the first one to the battery, from the battery connector to the switch. That's one. And then we need the battery connector to the switch on the other side, and thus do this one as well. So bear with me, I just need to trim this very slightly. And now, if you can see that, okay, so that's our negative connection, and we can just push that wire down thus. Right, so we've got one more connection to make now, and that is our resistor. Get it in shot, our resistor with the wire attached to the battery connector going to the atomizer. And that's proven to be a problem. So we just need to get some more solder on here. These are always a pain to get solder on. And we'll just do that again. Just touch that together. There we go. Oh, it's come off again. What I've found is sometimes it just doesn't want to stick at all, the solder. So I have to rough it up slightly. That's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to rough the edge just a tad. Right, so what I've just done there is use my little Dremel tool, and I've roughed up the surface, and that should help it, help the solder adhere when it's melted. So that's the first little bit, and then we're going to attach on the resistor. Should just be a case of a quick dab and attach. There we go. So there's a little tip for you. Just either use a bit of sandpaper or your Dremel tool and just rough the surface when you're adding these, that might help. Now what we're going to do is I'm just going to again clip that wire. So I'm now going to attach the other end of that wire to the other end of my LED, and again should just be a little touch, and there we have our circuit. And I've deliberately left these wires a little bit long in case I need to make any adjustments afterwards. But that is pretty much our box mod made. We've got the LED at the bottom, we've got the on-off switch, going to our horn switch, and then we've got the 510 connector. I'm just waiting for now some 14500 batteries to turn up. They should be here this week, and then I can put one in and I can show you it in use. But that is pretty much that box mod made. So I'll see you when I get my batteries. Okay, we are back. I now am in possession of two of these, and these are Trustfire 14500 900 milliamp 3.7 volt lithium ion batteries, and they're protected. Stealth Vape do recommend you use protected batteries with this particular mod, so I purchased a couple of these, and we'll just put the battery in and give it a quick test. And as you can see, the green light comes on. So we'll just test the voltages. Tankometer on and turn it on, green light comes on. Press the button, it turns to red. So let's see what the display says. And we'll do it around that way so you can see. There we go. And that's given us a voltage of 4 volts. So we are happy that this is all working. So what I'm going to do is just slip this battery out, and we're just going to secure everything now with some hot glue. And I have my trusty glue gun already heated up, and I'm just going to give it a bit of a squeeze. And lay down some glue, and I need to just push a new glue stick through. These are seven mil glue sticks. So what I'll do is I'll just push this through with the stick that is coming out. Really what we want to do is just make sure everything is lovely and solid in there. And not going to go anywhere. You could use some Araldite if you wanted. I just thought I'd use hot glue since I had quite a few hot glue sticks. And you can just buy them in bags for a few quid, and they're very handy, and this is fairly cheap. So there we go. That is now all solidly stuck together with glue. And just before I finish, I'm just going to make sure that nothing is going to get in the way of the top cover going on. So that's that bit. And while it's still malleable, just want to see that that fits, which it does. And oops, and while it is also still malleable, I want to make sure that my battery is still working, and yes it is. So I'm going to leave this to cool down and set nice and hard, and then I'm going to come back and we'll see how it vapes. See you in a minute. And welcome back. So it's built. The battery's in. If we turn it on, you can see that the LED glows red. When you press the button, it glows green. Now the LED will stay on until you flick off the switch, and then that makes it so it is completely off. So at least having that little LED glowing, you know that you are still using power. So let's put the tankometer on, and we'll just show that you are producing a voltage. So it's on, light has gone red, and we are on 4 volts. So I'm going to do is I'm going to put my little mini Vivian Nova tank on. There we are, still on,
And there you go. It works. Hey, it's alive! So it's working. I hope this will spur you to start your own modding. And like I said in the VT, this was the first time I've made one. So you saw it as I did it, so it is that easy to do. Obviously you need a little bit of soldering skills and a few little tools, but if you've got those already or you're thinking about buying those, then this isn't a bad little kit to start off with for the money. So there you go, that's the DIY box mod kit from Stealthvape, www.stealthvape.co.uk. You get a choice of boxes, choice of buttons, choice of resistors and a choice of LEDs. I'm working on another mod, it's a variable voltage box mod. This is going to be a twin 18650 variable voltage using a Mad Vapes kit with a display which is going to be on the back. I'm using my old tin, and this is the tin I used to use when I smoked, just to get the measurements and everything right. And then once it all looks good, I'm going to transfer everything into a brand new box which I got off an auction site. You can get these from your local market as well, they're quite cheap, a couple of quid. But it is quite large, but I've got big hands, so it's going to be quite good, I think, that one. So, that's my first mod. Like I said, I've started my second one. So this has been Marco Van Basten. You can catch me, as always, at ukvapors.org. You can find all my videos at my YouTube channel, which is The Van Bastens UK, and you can see me on a Tuesday night at Vapor Trails TV on Vapor Scene. Until I see you again, or until you see me again, happy vaping, peace out.